Getting people to vote, big problem, and especially young people. I mean, how would you address that, or what was your views on that, Pete?
Well, firstly, I accept that is a big problem, because I teach teenagers. Mm-hmm. Teenagers like to do a few things, in my opinion, often. And it's stuff their faces and play computers and maybe play sport. But, you know, there's a problem with civic engagement. I know the people who help me do me leaflets and do a bit of canvassing, they vote. Mm-hmm. And older people in this country who probably have seen governments rise and fall, they vote, because I think they get they understand. But young people, I don't think appreciate the significance of voting. I think you could offer them a voting from the age of 16, mm-hmm. give them a say. In the
get
voting.
Them younger, like, or...
Yeah, well, I don't see why you wouldn't, particularly for local elections, because I know, like, I work on the Sports Centre committee there in Cardiff, and the decisions we take essentially affect young people. Mm-hmm. How much we charge for the Astro, for example. Now, I'd love young people to feel that they had a say and all that, but they don't, do you know? And they feel they don't, and they choose not to. And also, I mean, well, let me put it this way. Now we have in most schools across Dublin 15, we have student councils.
Councils, yeah.
And they engage with the staff and management on issues of any concern to them. That's a huge start. But we need a CSPE programme that can bring that type of mentality out into the wider public. It's a huge issue. But again, like anything, Dublin 15 has 100,000 people. We have in the region about 10 secondary schools. You can't have everyone reinventing the wheel in every individual school. I think it should be dictated from the department down to say, as part of your part of the policies of the school, that you're going to encourage civic activity from your students. And be that, for example, getting out and cleaning up their community. We're facing at the community cleaner community awards again. Why can't we get young people involved in all of that? Why does it always have to be, you know, three or four local people in the community trying to do it all on their own? Mm. So I do see it as a problem. I don't necessarily have the answer either, you know.
No, but I mean, but I can see, take your point that if you get people in, you know, younger, like, under civic responsibility, because I remember civics myself back in school, and engage in that way, like, then the logical next step then, that if you want to participate, like, or have a say, like, then you vote. And maybe, as you just said, like, if a person gets in there younger, you know, at a younger age, like, they would actually see the benefit of it.
Another thing I'll tell you as well, I've had the benefit of having a good job, which was I'm a teacher. Mm-hmm. And for someone like myself...
Well, it's good of you to say that, because a lot of teachers mightn't say that.
Well, let me put it this way. I grew up in a place where, you know, teaching was a good job and still is. I'm very thankful for it. But the point was, I could bring out a load of lads from the local school and give them a few bob back in when I first got elected, and that kind of got them active. But let me put it this way. If you're going to run a local election campaign, you have to be prepared to spend a couple of grand on posters alone.
Yeah.
You know, that prohibits young people from running for anything, you know. I'd take a bank loan out to run in 2009. You know, so let's get real about this. Let's ban posters, for example, you know, and give them a real opportunity to get elected, you know. Yeah.